My name is Teresa. Thank you so much for clicking. It means so much. If you'd like to subscribe, I would love for you to join the family. And we have a pretty awesome time here. So for today's video, I want to do something a little different. I used to hate to read until age 17 when I read the Twilight series. That is the series that truly sparked my love for reading. So recently I went to the bookstore and actually the ladies there saved a Twilight, a book by Stephanie Meyer that's a Twilight. There's a Twilight book that they knew I would want. I picked up the Twilight Saga, the official illustrated guide by Stephanie Meyer. And it was super, super cheap. I got so excited because it's full of just all this information about the whole Twilight series and people and the covens and just so many details. But I know I've been searching for it for a long time, and as I started to read it, I just thought it would be fun to read it to you. So this is gonna be a series where the object will be to read the whole book eventually. So the first section we will start with, probably, so a disclaimer is I am dyslexic and sometimes I mix up words or add words. So if something doesn't seem right with my reading, that is why. Okay, so this starts with introduction. It's gonna be so fun. I thought this was super cool. In the introduction, it's from Stephanie, and she says, "Dear reader, working on this guide has given me a chance to reflect on how much this story has changed my life. One of the best ways things have changed is the opportunity I've had to get to know so many of my readers. I'm always impressed by the funny, caring, interesting people you are. I truly feel that with your enthusiasm and dedication you've brought as much to this series as I have, Little Brown and I have been working hard to make this guide something special for you, and I hope that we've succeeded. I would never presume to expect that all the questions have been answered, but fingers crossed, I think we got the big ones, plus many more. No one's ever asked me before. Enjoy." I forgot how nervous I get when I read out loud. Okay, the first section is a conversation with Shannon Hale. So this will be an interview with Stephanie Meyer by Shannon Hale. It says that at first Stephanie was a little bit apprehensive of doing another interview, but her best author friends forever, Shannon Hale, another author, decided to do the interview, and it was a whole weekend of them hanging out and then asking the questions. So we have Shannon Hale and then Stephanie Meyer. So I'll say Shannon and Steph. On how it all began. Shannon Hale. So let's look at the four different books first. Twilight. It started with a dream. Stephanie Meyer. Right. I should tell you the story to get it on record. Shannon. Do you want to? Stephanie. I'd like to. The story always sounds really fake to me. And when the publicist told me I needed to tell it, because it was good for publicity reasons, I feel like a lot of people were gonna say, you know, that's ridiculous. She's making up a silly thing to try to get attention. But nothing but the cold hard facts of how I got started as a writer. Usually I wake up around 4 o'clock in the morning. I think it's a baby thing left over from knowing that somebody needs me. Then I go back to sleep. That's when I would have the most vivid dreams, those morning hours. And those are the ones you remember when you wake up. So the dream was me looking down on the scene. It was in this meadow. There was so much light. The dream was very, very colorful. I don't know if that's always come through in my writing, but that is a prism effect, was just so brilliant. Shannon, the sunlight on Edward's skin? Stephanie, yeah, there was this beautiful image, this boy just glittering with light and talking to this normal girl. And the dream really was about him. He was also listening, as I was, but he was the one telling the story. It was mostly about how much he wanted to kill her, yet how much he loved her. In the dream, I think I'd gotten most of the way through what's chapter 13 now? The part where he recounts how he felt in each specific previous scene was obviously added later. But I hadn't written those earlier scenes yet. But everything else in this scene was mostly what they were actually talking about in the dream. Even the analogy about food was something that I got in my dream. I was so intrigued when I woke up. I just sat there and thought, how does this end? Does he kill her? Because it was really close. And you know how in dreams, it's not just what you hear, but it's also the feeling that's going on. And you see everything and the person in your head sees. So I knew how close it was. I mean, there was just a thin, thin line between what he was going to choose. So I wondered, how would he have made that work? What would be the next step for a couple like this? This is fun, right? I had recently started realizing that my memory was going and that I could no longer remember whom I had said something to yesterday. My youngest was just passing one and the next one was only two. I had an almost 5-year-old and my brains were like oatmeal. There was nothing left. So I knew I was going to forget this story. That realization was something that really hurt me. You know, when I was a kid, I always told myself stories. I didn't write them down. I didn't have to. My memory was great then. So I could always go back and revisit the one about this and the one about that and go over and refine it. But this one was going to get lost if I didn't do something about it. So after I got the kids' breakfast done, I only had 2 hours for swim lessons. Even though I should have been doing other things, I started writing it out. It wasn't the dream so much as the day of writing that made me a writer, because the dream was great and it was a good story. But if I'd had my memory, it would have stayed just a story in my head. And I would have figured out everything that happened and told it to myself, but that would have been it. That would have been so sad. We wouldn't have had Twilight. But writing it down, making it real, and being able to go back and reread sentences was just a revelation to me. It was this amazing experience. Wow, this is what it's like to write down stories. I was hooked. I just couldn't quit. I used to paint when I was in high school particularly. I won a few awards. I was okay with watercolors. My mom still has some hanging up in her house. Slightly embarrassing, but they're decent. I was not a great painter. It was not something I should have pursued as a career by any stretch of the imagination. I could see a picture in my head, but I could not put it on canvas the way it was in my head. That was always a frustration. When I started writing, I immediately had a breakthrough. I can make it real if I write it, and it's exactly the way I see it in my head. I didn't know I was able to do that. So that was really the experience that made me a writer and made me want to continue being one. Oh, I'm so happy she's a writer. Okay, Shannon. So you started out writing out the meadow scene. Where did you go from there? Stephanie. I continued to the end, chronologically, which I don't always do anymore. Shannon, so you didn't go back to the beginning because you wanted to know what's going to happen next? Stephanie, I was just like any reader with the story. You want to find out what happens. The backstory was for later. I wasn't really that worried about it. I wanted to see where it was going to go. So I kept writing. The last chapter just kept getting longer and longer. Then I made epilogue after epilogue. There were so many things I wanted to explore, like why this was this way and why that was that way and how Bella first met Alice and what their first impressions were. So I went back and did the beginning and found it exciting to be able to flesh it all out, give reasons for everything that had happened later. I had lettered all my chapters instead of numbering them. Interesting. So I went back and did A, and I think I had a chapter 13 being E because I thought maybe 5 or 6 chapters of material would cover the beginning. Then it was like 12, so I was surprised about that. Shannon, you were surprised about how much had really happened beforehand? Stephanie, yeah, it just kept on going on. I was thinking, wow, this is taking a long time. And that's where I finally ended, which was the last sentence in chapter 12. I knew I had crossed the continent with the railroad, and this was the golden spike that was being driven. It was all linked together, and that was the moment of shock when I thought, it's actually long enough to be considered a book-length thing, some kind. It's actually considered long enough to be a book-length thing of some kind. Oh, how exciting.
Shannon,
you really didn't even consider it like a book until then? Stephanie, no. No, I think if I would have thought of it as a book, I would have never finished it. I think if I would have thought halfway, you know, maybe I can make this into a book, maybe I can do something with this, then the pressure would have crushed me and I would have given up. I'm really glad I didn't think of it that way. I'm glad I protected myself by just keeping it about my personal story for me alone. Shannon, and you were thinking of yourself as a reader the whole time? Stephanie, yes, yes, well, I'm kind of shy, and I obviously had to get over that in a lot of ways, but the essential Stephanie, who is still here, has a really hard time letting people read things that she writes.
She laughed.
And there's a lot of enjoyment, which I'm sure you've experienced, in letting someone read what you write. There's also fear of it. It's a really vulnerable position to put yourself in.
Okay, I think that is good for now.
Let's see how far I need it. Made it to page 6. That was really fun. I actually really like reading out loud. It like brings me a lot of joy, and it was just so cool to see her initial answers and her laughs in between. And like, if she wouldn't have written down her dream, we would have never had Twilight. Like, okay, thank you so much for watching, and if you would like to see more of these videos, you should like this video, and hopefully I will be able to get another one out. Remember, you can find magic wherever you look. Sit back and relax. All you need is a book. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you in the next videos. Bye!